I'm hunting wabbits. Wabbit! Die, rabbit! Welcome to the SKS episode, guys. Follow me.
SKSR rifles are back into the program. We did something really cool, guys, and I thought I would share what I have found out and how is it looking like. So you can see two basic versions of Norinco, so-called paratrooper. This one is 16 and a half inch barrel, and then we got the Norinco with the full length barrel, 20 and a half inches. So 4 inches barrel differences between these two rifles. I put them through the Doppler radar to see how these are really performing versus each other, because I learned to not trust some of the infos posted online and things like this. I always like to check what's really is happening with the rifles on my own. And guys, as predicted, the shorter barrel rifle speeds, muzzle velocities were around 100 feet per second slower versus a full version 20 and a half inch version. Surprisingly, on the Wolf ammo, this is a standard full metal jacket Wolf ammo, the short barrel rifle, 16 and a half inch SKS placed outstanding results on the standard deviation. On a 10 shot string, the standard deviation was in single digits. I think it was like 9.7 if I remember. And the extreme spread was very, very slow. Then we used the Barnall ammo too. On the Barnall ammo was not as bad as well. It was way below 20 feet per second. So from both Barnall ammo and from the Wolf, both rifles performed very well. You have to remember that this is the rather cheap ammo, and in both cases, either the Wolf or the Barnall. But I was really taken and surprised by how well that Wolf ammo clocked on the radar. Very consistent ammo. I was not expecting this to see. So whatever Wolf is doing, please keep doing it. But going back to the performance differences. So we know that the longer SKS, or should I say rather standard length SKS, will deliver the higher speeds versus the shorter barrel. Now the advantage, of course, of the shorter barrel or that so-called paratrooper SKS is it is much easier to move it and navigate, and it's much more handy. So a lot of people from the shooting community really looks for these paratrooper SKSs. They really enjoy them and they really like them and prefer over the longer barrel rifle or SKS. And it is true, it's really like if you keep using these SKSs, you quickly will learn that this is really handy, it's really cool. I really like how this rifle welds to the body and everything. That being said, there is nothing wrong in my eyes with the standard length SKS. But if we will start pushing those SKSs and just to have fun, I'm not saying, guys, that this is a, you know, some magic sniper rifle or anything. This is not the role of the SKS rifle, as we know. But you can push them successfully through the 300, 400, and 500 yards. For me, on iron sights like this and 7.62 by 39, I'm clocking my limit at the 500 yards. I can push from time to time myself to past 600, but it's really hard with 7.62 by 39, especially if you do have a windy day. You have to have a really, really good spotter and start immediately dialing corrections, not dialing, but correcting on the wind. And with these iron sights, it's rather kind of difficult. You have to start doing the holdovers and you have to be consistent on that. And then the wind is changing and things like this. But enough with the excuses. What I'm trying to say is when I'm shooting at the extended ranges, I prefer the longer barrel rifle. That 100 feet per second more basically buys me a flatter trajectory. And on 500 yards, if I remember this correctly, you gaining almost 6.5-7 inches less drop versus the 16.5 barrel. So if you can imagine, this is more like probably from the top of the head to somewhere here, you're going to have around 7.5-7 inches less drop thanks to those extra 4 inches. As far as the wind goes at 500 yards, you're not gaining that much. It's just probably around 2 inches less wind drift. Still, it adds up. Everything adds up. But as you can see clearly, you know, you can squeeze out more. That's why people probably are saying that these are more accurate. And I wouldn't say that this is the magic, the longer barrel contributes to accuracy. If you will put them at the 100 yards, probably they will clock or print on the paper the same groups, around 3 MOA, right? Maybe if we are lucky, we'll have 2 MOA groups. So at the 100 yards, they are the same, but because of that extra speed, you can put and squeeze out the extra mileage from it. So something to think about it. If you are looking for the SKS to have a fun test 100 yards, I wouldn't hesitate and absolutely roll with the standard SKS. Don't kill yourself. They are still very affordable, way below $400 if you look in the good places, and you can get it. But then also, if you want to have some CQB fun and things like this, the 16.5 inch version works extremely well. These are a little bit harder to find, but they are still out there, Norinkos, and you can have them too. You just have to, like I learned from looking through the local gangsters and things like this, you just have to have a date. They walk in and be lucky, okay? This rifle, by the way, this rifle came from friends at SK71, so thanks for that. But if you look, they are still out there and you can get them. At this point, I would say get the SKS, get the SKS rifle. They are tons of fun to shoot. We have done a few videos already on SKSs, and every time I'm picking up that rifle, there's something special. It brings smile to my face. I literally love them. They are outstanding rifles. And also, if you want to squeeze out that 7.62x39, you want to have some trainer rifle with the iron sights and have some fun, this will absolutely deliver, and you will be tested, and it will push you harder. But you can definitely make those hits at 500 yards, and if you work harder, probably 600, squeeze it out. Why not? So this is basically it. The raw data, 100 feet per second difference. Is it worth it of the weight of the extra 4 inches? That's up to you to decide, but at least you know, you have seen the screenshots from the Doppler radar, from the lab radar, and you know what we're dealing here with. So hopefully that answers some basic questions. Thanks for watching. Let me know if you have any questions about these SKS rifles, and even if I don't know the answer, I'll try to dig it out for you.